So today we're going to talk about Bettercomb and a kit that you can get from BetterBee where you can put everything together yourself. This is synthetic pre-drawn beeswax. Bettercomb sends frames and they sell them pre-wired, but they've recently run out of stock on those. So one option is to get a kit from BetterBee, and it's the Bettercomb Complete Unassembled Kit. Now, I paid full price for this. I did not get any kickbacks. I get no kickbacks by sharing it with you. I just want to talk to you about it and demonstrate how to wire your own frames without any jigs or fancy stuff. The kit includes that wire crimper. It includes a roll of B-wire, which we just showed, which is good for about 50 deep or 100 medium frames. You also get that eyelet punch and the eyelets that come with it. You get a lot of eyelets and, of course, these little nails, two of those for each frame, and that's how you're going to terminate your wires. And then we've got nails, of course, that hold all your frames together, so you can glue them and then nail them, or you can just glue them with some really good glue like I do. You also get this wire embedding device. You do not get a battery with it, so you're going to hook this up to a 12-volt battery system, which I will do here to demonstrate it. I also got my own needle nose pliers, the kind with teeth on it, so you can really grip the wire and pull it tight. This is my great grandfather's finishing hammer, so I like to use that too. Anyway, so here are the frames. Again, they come disassembled, so you have to glue them up. I glued them up myself, and I found that I can get away without even putting brads or nails in them. This is my 14th year of beekeeping. And I've seen no difference between those that get glued and nailed and those that just get glued. Also, if you're putting Bettercomb in these, you got to mark each frame top bar to make sure that you don't confuse them with other comb, because you're not going to be able to tell the difference once it's in the beehive. So these are also grooved. These frames are multi-purpose, not just for Bettercomb. So you can put plastic foundation in them, but I'm doing this to pre-wire and, of course, use the wire in the Bettercomb. This is a premium wood glue tight bond 2, water resistant interior exterior, and it's approved for exposure to food preparation surfaces, so not bad for your beehive. And again, I just used a quick grip clamp here and put that on it just so it'll spool out. I also clipped the bitter end of the wire to one of the grounding clips over there just to hold it and keep it from running free on you. This is a 2x4, nice and dirty from a chicken coop that runs all the way to the floor, and I use this kind of as a wooden anvil. So I can put my frames on that and tap in those eyelets and not vibrate the table like crazy. So we're going to demonstrate the whole thing. You're going to see. So here we go. Let's get the frame up here and we'll get the little eyelets. And of course the eyelet punch that comes with it. And the first thing I'm going to do is nail these little termination tacks that go in. Just nail it down enough so that there's clearance so I can wrap the wires around them. It's pretty simple. No jigs, no fancy stuff. You can just do it by hand. Of course, you can see that this is expertly done. A few taps with the hammer, get that in there. Next step is going to be, of course, to put those eyelets in with the eyelet punch. And here we go. I'm not going to make you watch me do every one. We're going to knock out 10 frames here and get the Bettercomb in them so we can have hot standby for any swarms that might be coming around this time of year. And I'm a believer in Bettercomb and how it works. Originally, they had us do these with toothpicks. We have decided collectively that that is kind of a fail, and toothpicks do not support your Bettercomb well enough. It is a synthetic pre-drawn comb that is made out of material that is almost chemically identical to actual beeswax, but it is not beeswax, so you have to label it, you have to keep it separate, and you of course don't want to eat it for chunk honey and things like that. So mark the frames. That's all I'm going to say about that. And these eyelets are going to give you a guide to run your wire through so it does not get hung up or cut into the wooden sidebars here. And we have four on each side. These are the deep frames. This kit cost me $109.95. So it included enough wire for 50 deep or 100 frames. The eyelets, enough for 20 deep or 40 medium frames. 1 pound of frame nails. It's enough to assemble 100 frames. And 100 5/8 inch wedge nails. Those are used to anchor the wire on both ends. And there's enough of those for 50 frames. And a cardboard shim, of course, also, so you can put the stuff in. And the wire crimper, eyelet punch, And this included the 10-pack of unassembled groove top frames. So you can get these deep or medium. I'm using deeps because when I'm setting up a brand new swarm, I'm going to put them in a deep box, and I want them this time of year, especially because it is September 5th. I want any bees going into a box to have every advantage they can possibly get, and synthetic Bettercomb has been the best way I've found to get them going. Now, if you already have used comb that has full deep drawn cells, use those. But these are nice and clean. There are no pesticides in them. There's no residue from other beehives. We don't have to worry about passing on any kind of germs, bacteria, any potential disease from other hives. These are absolutely clean, and the bees take to them right away. So all I do is draw it all the way through there. Again, no jigs, nothing like that. I wrap the end around that pin, what they call wedge nails, and then I just take the other end with my nice grippy needle nose pliers there. I pull it tight, and then I run that around the other wedge nail, and it actually snaps right off just from twirling it there. And then we're going to see how tight they are. So you can hear that that bottom one there is a little loose. So what am I going to do about that? Well, I'm going to use the wire crimper that came with it. Tightens things right up really quick. You can even use that on old frames that have wire reinforcement going through them. You can tighten them up over and over if they're ever loose. There you go. Now we're nice and tight, and we're ready to embed them in that Bettercomb. So we just go over the parts that are included again. They give you this little bag of eyelets. Now I put these in plastic peanut butter jars, so I'm dumping everything together that goes together so I don't have to go hunting around later. Don't forget also to drop your eyelet punch in that same plastic jar if you're going to be organized about it. Sometimes I like to use tackle boxes and things like that to organize things, but these little plastic jars allow me to attach them underneath of shelves. So 1/2 ounce of the eyes, 1 pound of 1¼ inch nails. That's to put your frames together. I did not use these for this demonstration. They are galvanized. And these are the jars. Just going to put them away. I'm just sharing you how I organize my things. So there they go. Here are the eyelets. Next time I need to do this, I know right where to go to grab them. So nice and tidy. Now we're going to open up the Bettercomb. It comes in boxes of 10. And they've come a long way, actually, even in the way they ship them, because the initial ones came through, they had nothing between the comb. So it actually stuck together. I used to end up tearing them apart a little bit, getting them away from each other. But now they've put a nice wax paper material between each and every comb. So there you have it, a 10-pack. So we're going to put 10 of them together. And again, as I said, have them on hot standby, because if you're installing a package, which you wouldn't be this time of year, this is for swarms. Now notice, these cells are angled. You want them to angle down towards the center. You do not want them like this, angling down away from the center, because the bees won't use them if this is the angle that goes up. So you want it like this, like a V when they go in. Plus the sides are tapered here, and that will allow you to insert it into the frame. So whether they're frames that you've put together or those provided by BetterBee that are complete, it's all going to be the same. And of course, that's wire embedder. And when I use this hooked up to my charger here, I could be embedding these for hours on end. This charger, DSR Pro Series, PSJ2212 is the model. This thing works fantastic. It's also good for oxalic acid vaporization while we're at it. So here we go. We're going to embed the wires into this Bettercomb. And make sure that you're making contact with the outermost wires. If you don't put your conductors on the outermost wires, guess what? They won't heat up and it won't sink into the Bettercomb. For example, see the end that's facing us here? If you put it on those two wires there, then the outermost wires won't heat up and won't sink in. They'll stay on top. So there we go. Nice and quick. Embedded those wires right into the Bettercomb. And again, just reminding you, mark them distinctly so that even years from now, you're going to know which ones have the Bettercomb in them, because you cannot sell or advertise that as actual beeswax, even though chemically very, very similar to the exact composition of the wax that bees make themselves. So here we go. I'm just going to embed a bunch of them so you can see it over and over here really quick. You want to wait till they heat up. There is a cardboard shim that matches underneath of the Bettercomb, and that allows it to push up just the right amount. You want to push the wires in until they embed themselves right down to that center, what would be a wax foundation piece in the middle. Make sure they make contact with that. The beep on my 12-volt system there is just to let me know that it's still on. And I can do this over and over. Just keep going. I won't bore you to death with it, but I want you to see it happen several times. Never touch the wires with your bare hands. Of course, when there's electricity contacting it, you can get a nice zap. They also heat up pretty good, so keep your hands off of them. Just make sure it's all centered. Now, we found out if you don't put wire in this Bettercomb, then it tends to sag on hot days. Even in the northeastern United States, I had some of this sag a little. Those who live in the southern states, places where it gets significantly hotter, desert southwest, places like that, you do not want to be using deep frames of Bettercomb without wire reinforcement. Doing it yourself is going to save you quite a bit of money. Plus, there is the additional problem with the fact that BetterBee doesn't even have the pre-wired frames in stock. That's why I decided to do this video, to show you that there's a kit that you can do it yourself, and that once you get the materials, the wire, the eyelets, the frame nails, the wedge nails, the wire crimper, the eyelet punch, and all the other stuff you need, then all you have to do is buy the wooden frames, put them together yourself, you'll save money, and it's very easy to do. Then you can store them away and have them whenever you're doing maintenance on a hive. Maybe you're going to pull out old beeswax and you want to substitute new. I don't fill entire boxes with this when I'm starting out a package or hiving a swarm. I only put 3 or 4 frames of it in there to get them going. Then you can leave the outermost frames with acorn heavy wax frames, or you can do foundationless, whatever you'd like to do. Because once the bees are established, they have the numbers to do it all. Here's 10 frames, nicely done, sitting inside this hive butler tote, which holds them really nice. So I can just carry this out in the bee yard with me when I'm doing inspections, if I'm pulling a frame, or if I'm installing something. Now I'm just showing you really quickly, this is September 5th. I had to add emergency boxes to a lot of these hives because everyone seems to be in a state of rapid buildup right now. These bees are bringing in pollen like crazy. There's a population explosion going on. These are Saskatrass bees. The other thing is, I recently collected a swarm on September 1st. This is just the 5th, and I want you to notice they are bringing in pollen already. And I attribute that completely to the fact that I installed several frames of Bettercomb in this hive with this swarm, and they are kicking it in 5th gear right now. Lots of brood, lots of eggs, which means that this queen went to laying within the first couple of days of being hived in this box. So things are looking great. You want to speed things up? Get Bettercomb. You want to be able to do a lot of it for a very low price, very easy? Get the kit. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.